Hello guys, Dr. Carlo here. I am posting a follow-up on the hair tourniquet video. That's the little kid with the finger that was tied around with a hair. Basically, that's what it's called. So let's talk a little bit about hair tourniquets. Anytime you have a child who's crying and you don't know why, especially if they don't have a fever, that's one of the first things I look for. I take all the socks and look for hair tourniquets in their toes and fingers. I've looked for it hundreds, maybe thousand times, never seen one. Seen in pictures, tests, and things like that. Told my mid-levels to look for it, but I've never actually seen one like that. This was tied in so tight, and probably wasn't that tight, but with the swelling happening, it essentially is a tourniquet. If left alone, that finger will die and end up resulting in amputation. Usually the kids are in much pain, but after a while it's been there, the nerves start getting numb. And then they don't have that much pain. Like this kid, if you weren't touching him, he was fine. But you could see the purple toe distally. The treatment for it is to get the hair fibers out. And the mom had already done that by unwrapping some of the hair, but some of it was deeper. Basically what I did, I take a number 11 blade, that's the really sharp blade that has a very sharp angle on the tip, and just slowly and gently started scratching it and started removing fibers from it. I did get a fair amount of fibers, but the finger and the toe never turned like normal color. It was still purple. So my question was whether or not I actually achieved normal circulation. I wasn't sure of that, so I referred him. I actually transferred the kid to a pediatric hospital where possibly a surgeon was going to evaluate the finger and do an incision. Now, theoretically, it's not a difficult process. All you have to do is get deep enough to cut. And if you think about it, you can make a laceration on the skin. Just go deep enough, cut it, and it comes out. Do it in a way that you avoid the nerves. So usually the nerves of the finger go on the lateral side. So you would do it on the kind of like on an angle right here, like that, because you got tendon here. You don't want to cut that. So here, here, or I guess you could do it here, but there's another tendon there. So I think on the side here, top or bottom, would have been a good place to do a cut, and then end up with relieving this. But honestly, I hadn't done one in ever. So I didn't feel comfortable with my technique, so I refer him where he can get some adequate treatment. So that's the follow-up. I don't know what happened, whether or not he went to actual surgery or they did a procedure right at the bedside, but I wrapped him up with lidocaine with epinephrine and stuff before he left. That way by the time he got there, hopefully it'd be numb and they can do whatever they needed to do. And that's it for the update. See ya.